Hello kids, welcome back to our English class. So today we are going to start a new lesson called The Pied Piper of Hamelin. The Pied Piper of Hamelin. Please open page number 40. So before learning this lesson, we will learn some new words. So see here, what do you mean by prosperous? Prosperous means rich. Prosperous means rich. Shatter means break into tiny pieces. Gnaw means bite something. Gnaw means bite or nibble something. Invade means enter somewhere with force. Florin means British coin. Scampering means run with small step. Nook means corner. Cranny means small narrow space. Cellar means a room below ground level in a house. To wound one's way means to move through some area. So now we will start the lesson. See here. Long, long ago, on the banks of River Weser in Germany, lay a little town called Hamelin. The people of Hamelin were happy and content. Most of them were farmers or fishermen. They earned their livelihood by working very hard on their farms and fishing in many little streams. As the years went by, the people became rich and prosperous. Long, long ago, bahut bahut pehle, on the banks of River Weser in Germany lay a little town called Hamelin. Banks means nadi ka kinara. On the banks of River Weser, which river? Weser, there laid a little town called Hamelin. Bahut saal pehle वेसर नदी के किनारे पे गांव था. वेर इज वेसर? वेसर इज इन जर्मनी. वेसर नदी कहाँ पे है? जर्मनी में. इस नदी के किनारे एक गांव था, छोटा सा गांव था, उसका नाम था हैमलिन. द टाउन नेम वॉज हैमलिन. द पीपल ऑफ हैमलिन वर वेरी हैप्पी एंड कॉन्टेंट. पीपल ऑफ हैमलिन वर हैप्पी एंड कॉन्टेंट. हैमलिन के लोग बहुत ही क्या थे? खुश थे और जो था उसमें आनंदमयी थे. मोस्ट ऑफ देम वर फार्मर्स और फिशरमैन. उनमें से ज़्यादातर लोग फिशरमैन थे या फिर फार्मर्स थे. एक तो मछली पकड़ने वाले थे या फिर खेती करने वाले थे. दे अर्न देयर लाइवलीहुड बाय वर्किंग वेरी हार्ड ऑन देयर फार्म एंड फिशिंग इन देयर मैनी लिटिल स्ट्रीम्स. दे यूज टू फिश वेयर इन द स्ट्रीम्स. स्ट्रीम्स मीन्स स्मॉल रिवर्स. दे यूज टू earn their livelihood by working on their farms or fishing in many little stream. They used to farm and fishing. As the years went by, the people became rich and prosperous. As they used to do farming or fishing, they became very prosperous. They became rich. They got very much money. Then suddenly what happened? Suddenly one day, their peace was shattered. Shatter means break into many pieces. One day, their peace was shattered. Let's see how. The entire town was invaded by rats. The entire town was invaded by what? Rats. Rats entered their town at a large level. At first, the cats of Hamelin had a party, but soon they got tired. The rats were multiplying too fast. Even the cats ran away to hide from the army of rats. Suddenly what happened? Their peace. People of Hamelin's peace was shattered because of rats. There entered too many rats in Hamelin. At first, the cats of Hamelin had party. Who eats rat? Cats, yes. Cats eat rats. But as the cats started multiplying, even cats ran away. Rat ko kon khata hai? Chuho ko kon khata hai? Billiyan, cats. Pehle to jab rats Hamelin mein enter hue, tab billiyon ki party ho gayi. But then as soon as rats were multiplying means jab रैट्स बहुत ही ज़्यादा होने लगे. इवन द कैट्स रैन अवे. इवन द कैट्स रैन अवे. बिल्लियाँ भी भाग गई जब रैट्स की संख्या बहुत सारी हो गई. कैन यू इमेजिन? द रैट्स अटैक द बार्न्स एंड स्टोर हाउसेस. दे gnawed एट द वुड. दे gnawed एट द क्लोथ्स. दे gnawed एट एवरीथिंग दैट केम इन देयर वे. रैट अटैक्ड व्हाट? बार्न्स. बार्न्स मीन्स द प्लेस वेर यू स्टोर योर क्रॉप्स एंड ऑल. एंड स्टोर हाउसेस. रैन अटैक्ड बार्न्स एंड स्टोर हाउसेस टू ईट फूड. दे gnawed. gnawed मीन्स टू बाइट और निबल समथिंग. दे gnawed एट वुड. पहले तो वो लकड़ियाँ खाने लगे. दे gnawed एट क्लोथ्स. फिर कपड़े चबाने लगे. दे gnawed एट एवरीथिंग दैट केम इन देयर वे. जो भी उनके रास्ते आता वो उसे चबाने लगते. दे इवन बाइट बेबीज इन देयर क्रिब्स. वो बच्चों को भी काटने लगे. द सिटीजन्स कुड बियर इट नो लॉन्गर. द सिटीजन्स कुड टेक इट नो लॉन्गर. दे अप्रोच द मेयर ऑफ द हैमलिन. The town councillors and the mayor were thinking of a plan to get rid of the cat, of the rats. There was a loud knock at the door. Who was thinking to get rid of the rats? Town councillors and mayor. They were thinking how to get rid of these rats who are troubling our people. Then there was a knock on the door. Who that can be? They wondered. Who wondered? मेयर एंड दी काउंसिलर्स वंडर हु दैट कैन बी. किसने डोर पर नॉक किया होगा. एज दे ओपन द डोर दे सॉ अ टॉल थिन मैन ड्रेस्ड इन ब्राइटली कलर्ड क्लोथ्स. जैसे ही उन्होंने दरवाजा खोला दे सॉ अ मैन अ थिन मैन ड्रेस्ड ब्राइटली इन ब्राइटली कलर्ड क्लोथ्स. रंग बिरंगी कपड़ों में एक पतले से आदमी को उन्होंने देखा. ही हैड अ ब्लू फेदर इन हिज रेड हैड. Which color feather? He had a blue feather in what? In his tall red hat. See here, you can see here. He had a blue feather in his tall and red hat. He was carrying a golden pipe. What was he carrying? He was carrying a golden pipe. Can you see this pipe? It is his golden pipe. So, he says, Sirs, I have freed other towns of beetle and bats. I can rid your town of rats. I'll charge 1,000 florins for this. So basically he has come to help mayor and councillors here to get rid of the cats. So he is offering them his help, but with the exchange of some money. So he says, Sirs, I have freed other towns of beetle and bats. Maine dusre gaon mein इंसेक्ट्स भगाए हैं, बीटल्स भगाए और बैट्स भी भगाए. मैं आपकी भी हेल्प कर सकता हूँ चूहे भगाने के लिए. बट आई विल चार्ज व्हाट? आई विल चार्ज 1,000 florins. Florins वर ब्रिटिश कॉइन्स. सो द मेयर एक्सक्लेम्ड, 1,000 florins? वी विल गिव यू 50,000 इफ यू सक्सेड. मेयर ने कहा, सिर्फ 1,000 florins? मैं तुम्हें 50,000 florins दूंगा अगर तुम चूहों को भगाते हो. द वेरी नेक्स्ट डे एट डॉन द पाइपर टुक आउट हिज पाइप एंड बिगैन टू प्ले सॉफ्ट मैजिकल म्यूजिक. एट द डॉन, शाम होते ही, ही स्टार्टेड द पाइपर टुक आउट हिज पाइप एंड बिगैन टू प्ले सॉफ्ट मैजिकल म्यूजिक. वो मधुर संगीत बजाने लगा अपने पाइप से. As he made his way through the lanes of Hamelin playing on his flute, rats began scampering out from nooks, crannies, cellars and basements, gutters and pipes. There were big rats and little rats, brown rats and black rats, fat rats and thin rats. They all followed him as if it were a military parade. The next day when he started playing his pipe, what happened? As he made his way through the lanes of Hamelin, जैसे ही वो Hamelin के रास्तों पर से गुजरने लगा उसका म्यूजिक बजाते हुए फ्लूट पे, rat began scampering out. Scampering means run with small steps. चूहों ने उसके पीछे भागना शुरू कर दिया. कहाँ से भागना शुरू कर दिया, वो कहाँ से निकलने लगे? They began scampering out from nooks, crannies, cellars, basements, gutters and pipe. हर जगह जहाँ जहाँ चूहे थे वहाँ सबसे चूहे बाहर आकर उसे फॉलो करने लगे. There were big rats and little rats. वहाँ पे कौन कौन से प्रकार के चूहे थे? Big rats, बड़े rats, little rats, छोटे rats, brown rats, black rats, fat rats, thin rats. And they all followed him as if it were a military parade. वो ऐसे उसे follow करने लगे जैसे कि वो military parade में जा रहे हैं. See here, can you see? There are all types of rats which are following the piper. Then what happened? The piper led them away from the town till he reached the river. He continued to play as he stepped into the river and the rats followed him. By the time the piper reached the middle of the river, all the rats had drawn and been swept away by the current. Piper did what? He played his soft magical music and he led all the cats to river and he continued to play as he stepped into the river and rats followed him. Rats followed him into the river and as soon as the piper reached in the mirror, all the rats had drawn. चूहों ने पाइपर का पीछा किया और नदी के बीचों बीच तक पीछा किया, फिर वो डूब गए. So basically, he got rid of all the cats. Then the town of Hamelin was at last free of rats. There were no rats in Hamelin at all. Hamelin was free of rats. The people were happy and relaxed. Now people were happy and relaxed. When the piper went to collect his reward, the mayor refused to pay him 50,000 florins. Mayor had told him to give him 50,000 florin if he gets rid of the cat. But mayor refused it. He did not keep his promise. Then mayor says, the rats are all dead now and they can never come back. So either take 50 florins or nothing at all. Now the mayor is saying, take this 50 florins or nothing at all. I will not give you anything. You can go. The piper was very angry. Pointing a finger at mayor, he said, you will regret that you broke your promise, sir. Now, piper got angry because mayor did not give him 50,000 florins as he promised. Now, he is telling mayor that he will regret because he broke his promise. Saying this, the piper disappeared. वो वहां से चला गया. At dawn the next day, the piper wound his way through the streets of Hamelin again, playing a different tune at this time. इस बार piper Hamelin के रास्तों से pipe को बजाते हुए चला गया. But this time the tune was different. This time tune was very much different. All the children came out of their homes and flocked around him. This time there were no rats. This time there were children who followed this piper. Children followed this piper and flocked around him. उसके आसपास झुंड बनाने लगे. He means the piper led them out of the town. Piper led children out of the town through a forest till they reached the foot of a huge mountain. फिर piper उन सब बच्चों को कहाँ लेके गया? एक पहाड़ के पास. The piper played another tune and a door opened. पहाड़ के पास जैसे ही उसने एक म्यूजिक बजाया, एक दरवाजा खुल गया. कहाँ पे? केव में. देर वॉज अ ह्यूज केव इनसाइड. वहां पे एक बहुत बड़ी गुफा थी. द चिल्ड्रन फॉलोड द पाइपर इंटू द केव. चिल्ड्रन फॉलोड द पाइपर इंटू द केव. When the last child had entered the mountain cave, the door shut and a large boulder rolled down to block the entrance to the cave forever. Children followed the piper to where? A mountain. when the last pipe, see here, the children followed the piper into the cave. बच्चों को कहाँ लेके गया? एक बड़ी सी गुफा में, पहाड़ के गुफा में लेके गया. When the last child entered the mountain cave, the door shut. जैसे ही एक बच्चा, last बच्चा, सारे बच्चे इसमें चले गए. Sorry, जैसे इसमें सारे बच्चे चले गए, तब उसका, उस गुफा का डोर बंद हो गया और एक बड़ा सा पत्थर वहाँ पे रोल डाउन होके आ गया और उसका एंट्रेंस बंद हो गया. ओनली वन लेम बॉय वॉज लेफ्ट बिहाइंड. ही रिटर्न टू हैमलिन एंड टोल्ड द सिटीजन्स वॉट हैड हैपेंड. एक बच्चा जो वहाँ पे रह गया था, ही केम बैक टू द टाउन, ही केम बैक टू हैमलिन. वो हैमलिन आकर वहाँ के लोगों को पूरा वाकिया बताने लगा, पूरी स्टोरी बताने लगा. Then what happened? The mayor and all the citizens of Hamlin never ever broke their promise again. After this incident, after the piper took all children of the town by playing his magical music, the mayor and all the citizens of Hamlin never broke their promise again. So kids, understood the story? I hope you have understood and also enjoyed the story. So now we will move to the exercise part. Can you tell me what is the moral of the story? So basically the moral is, you should never break your promise. If you have promised something to someone, you should do it. Understood? So see here, exercise part, match the words with their meanings, write the answers. What is stream? As I told you, stream is a small river. What is shatter? Shatter means break into tiny pieces. What is invade? Invade means enter somewhere with force. What is regret? Feeling sad. At the loss of something. What is prosperous? Prosperous means rich. Now next one. Select the correct word from the brackets and fill in the blanks. You need to select the correct word and you need to fill in the blanks. The dash attacked the barns and storehouses. What attacked the barns and storehouses? Were those cats, bats or rats? Rats. Rats. The rats attacked the barns and barn houses. They approached the dash of Hamlin. Who? Citizens of Hamlin approached the mayor of the Hamlin. The mayor gave dash florin as a reward. How many florins he gave? 50. Because of which Piper got angry, because he had promised to give 50,000. The Piper was very disappointed, sad or angry? Yes, he was angry because he did not get 50,000 florin from mayor. Only one dash boy was left behind. Lame. Now we will move to the question answer parts. So kids, now see here, answer the following questions. We have 5 questions here with the answers. First one is, how were the people of Hamlin? How were the people of Hamlin? Hamlin ke log kaise rehte the? Kaise the? The people of Hamlin were happy and content. The people of Hamlin were content and happy and content. Wo bahut hi khush aur sukhi rehte the. How did the people of Hamelin earn their livelihood? People of Hamelin के लोग अपना रोजगार कैसे चलाते थे? People of Hamelin earned their livelihood by working hard on their farms and fishing in the little streams. वो क्या करते थे? Farming करते थे और fishing करते थे in little streams. This is how they earned their livelihood. Third one is, why was the peace of people of Hamelin shattered? Hamelin ke logon ki shanti kyun bhang hui? And the answer is, the entire town was invaded by rats. They attacked barns, storehouses, chewed food, clothes and everything that came in their way. The entire town was invaded by rats. They attacked barns, storehouses, chewed food, clothes and everything that came in their way. Next question is, what happened when the piper started playing soft music on his pipe? When the piper started playing soft music, rats from every corner of the village came out and followed him. Next question is, where did the piper take the children? The piper took the children into the mountain cave. Now, fourth question is, who said these words to whom? So we have two sentences here. We need to write who said these words to whom. First one is, you will regret that you broke your promise, sir. Who said these words to whom? The piper said these words to mayor. You will regret that you broke your promise, sir. Next one is, I can rid your town of rats. I can rid your town of rats. The Pied Piper said these words to the mayor and two town councillors. Who said? The Pied Piper said these words to mayor and two town councillors. Now the fifth question is, write two sentences on each of the following. We need to write two sentences on each of these following. First one is Pied Piper. He was a thin, tall man. He could drive bats, beetles, rats, and cats away on the tune of his pipe. Next one is mayor. The mayor was the head of the town, Hamelin. Mayor kaun tha? Hamelin town ka head tha. He promised to pay 50,000 florin to the piper. But he cheated the piper and was ready to pay just 50 florins. Now next one is, use the words in the bracket and fill in the blanks. We need to use these words in the brackets and we need to fill in these blanks. Now see here, the crystal was dash as it hit the floor. क्रिस्टल वास जैसे ही फ्लोर को हिट किया वो क्या हो गया? शैटर्ड. The rats invaded. नेक्स्ट, मिसेस जेसी सर्च्ड एवरी डैश बट शी कुड नॉट फाइंड हर डॉग. मिसेस जेसी सर्च्ड एवरी nook and cranny, but she could not find her dog. I dashed to say that I will not be able to accept your invitation. The people of Hamelin were happy and content. The people of Hamelin were happy and content. Now next one is activity language development part. Synonyms. Read the word pairs that mean the same. Synonyms means words with the same meaning. Beautiful, pretty. Huge, big. Tiny, small. Wealthy, rich. Fast, quick. See, these are the synonyms. Synonyms means words with a similar meaning. Beautiful, pretty. दोनों का meaning same है. Huge, big. Tiny, small. Wealthy, rich. Fast, quick. Each word in a group A has words in group B and C that have the same meaning. Join the words with similar meaning from each group. One has been done for you. Group A, group B, group C have some words with similar meaning. We need to join those similar words. For example, cheerful, happy and joyful are same. Cheerful, happy and joyful are same. Now let's see the next one. Next one is cautious. Cautious means being alertful. Alertful means being careful. We will write here this A, B, so that we don't get confused. Next one is brilliant. Next one is brilliant. Brilliant means being bright. Then here, bright means shining. Next one is proud. Proud, dignified. Dignified means superior. Kids, now I'm doing it without scale. You need to do it with scale. Next one is narrow. Narrow means thin. Where is thin? See here, thin. Thin means narrow, thin, then restricted. Then chatter. Chatter means talk. Talk, speak. Then cold. Cold, freezing. Freezing means chill. Now last one is peace. Peace means calm. And the last option we have, what? Unity. Understood? So you need to do it properly. Now that I am holding phone, so I can't use both the hands. So you need to do what? You need to do these things properly with a scale. Okay? Now, see here, again it is written, two or more words having almost the same meaning are called synonyms. Do shabd jinke meaning almost same rehte hain, unhe hum kehte hain synonyms. Now next one is, in each set, the word, circle the word that has similar meaning as the word in the box. We need to circle the word that has similar meaning in the box. Gigantic. Gigantic means huge. Leap. Leap means jump. Simple. Simple means hard or easy? Simple means easy. Then alike. Alike means same. Close means shut. Bright means intelligent. Understood? So now we will move to the grammar part. Today we are going to learn about comparison of adjectives. So see here, note the underlined word that describes each pencil. Note this underlined words that describe the pencil. These underlined words are describing these pencils. What are adjectives? Adjectives are the words that describe the nouns. Now here these words are describing these pencils. Now you need to just, you do what? Note the underlined word that describes the pencils. Sania's pencil is long. Sania ki pencil kaisi hai? It is long. Sam's pencil is longer than Sania's pencil. Sam's pencil is longer than Sania's pencil. Sam ka pencil Sania ke pencil se bada hai. Sania ke pencil se Sam ka pencil bada hai. Okay? Here, Sam's pencil is longer than Sania's pencil. So, the word is longer. Longer than Sania's pencil. So, basically, Sania's pencil is shorter than Sam's pencil or smaller than Sam's pencil. Now between Sam and Sania, whose pencil is longer? Yes, Sam's pencil is longer than Sania's pencil. Now look at the third one. Soham's pencil is the longest of three pencils. Sam's pencil is longest. Sam's pencil is longest of the three pencils. It means Soham's pencil is longer than Sam's pencil as well as Sania's pencil. In teenon mein sabse badi pencil kiski hai? Soham's. Sabse badi pencil, longest. Long, longer, longest. Understood? Long, longer, longest. When you are comparing Sam's and Sania's pencil, Sam's pencil is longer than Sania's pencil but shorter than Soham's pencil. So, whose pencil is the longest one? Soham's. It is longest. It is longer than Sam's pencil and Sania's pencil. That is why it is longest. Understood? Long, longer, longest. See here, Sania's pencil is long, Sam's pencil is longer, Soham's pencil is longest of three pencils. Now read here, add er to the given adjective to compare two nouns. Add est to the adjective, compare when you are comparing three or more nouns. When you are comparing two nouns, you need to add er. When you are comparing three or more nouns, you need to add est. Now see here, long, longer, we added er, longer, when we are comparing two nouns. We are comparing two nouns here, Sam and Sania's pencil. But when we are comparing three or more nouns, we add est to it. Now the exercise related to this one, add er, est to the given adjective, complete the table, read the words, and one example has been done for us. See here, small, smaller, smallest. Pretty, prettier, prettiest. Now we need to write these one. Wise, wiser, wisest. Wise, wiser, wisest. Young, younger, youngest. Young, younger, youngest. Old, older, oldest. Sweet, sweeter, sweetest. Happy, happier, happiest. Wealthy, wealthier, wealthiest. Tricky, trickier, trickiest. Thick, thicker, thickest. See, wise, wiser, wisest, young, younger, youngest, old, older, oldest, sweet, sweeter, sweetest, happier, happy, happier, happiest, wealthy, wealthier, wealthiest, tricky, trickier, trickiest, thick, thickest, thicker, and thickest. So this is about comparison of adjectives. So kids, we have finished our lesson. So from next class, we will do the revision. So I hope you have understood this lesson. You understood this question answers as well. So kids, study well and take care. See you in next class.